Hey, I'm Tyler Blackburn, and thanks for watching Hollywire.
What's up, Hollywire? Talking to Tyler Blackburn. How's
Hello.
It going?
Good. Hi. Happy South By.
Okay, so we are going to play Holly Words with Tyler finally, right?
Yes, I
know. Okay, whatever it lands on, say the first thing that pops in your head. You can go ahead and spin it again if you'd like to.
Okay. Oh, that was not a good spin.
You could spin again.
No, that's fine. We'll see. Most embarrassing, like, moment of my life?
It could either be moment of your life, moment on set, moment that happened today.
One time when I was a kid, I was at a carnival. And like there was this huge line for this like ride that was kind of scary, and I had like long hair at the time. It was like, you know, early 90s. I had like a bowl haircut, and they were like, we have one spot opened, is there a single rider? And my dad was like, go, and I was like, okay, me. And I was like this little kid, and then someone was like, you're such a brave little girl. They thought I was a little girl. And that was pretty embarrassing. In that moment I was like, I don't feel brave anymore.
Did you still go on the ride?
Yeah, I went on the ride.
Okay, again?
Yes, let's do it.
Oh, it almost did it again.
It did.
Collab, like who would I want to collab with? Like Jurassic Park was my favorite movie growing up.
Wait, I was about to say, but I love Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
I just said it.
Yeah, so something like that. I guess that's sort of sci-fi adventure thriller, right?
Okay.
Not sci-fi like space, but like, no, I don't even know, like action adventure. I would love to do a movie like that. And I would love to work with, I feel like Jennifer Lawrence would be so fun to work with, right?
Yeah, and
like
fun.
She, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like it'd be a fun time.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
That'd be a great one.
Yeah.
Okay, please make this happen.
Yes, thank you. Jurassic Park number 16.
Right? It's turning you and Jennifer.
Yeah.
So we were talking about Jeanine a second ago.
Yes.
She's so sweet.
I know. I love her so much.
You can gush. She gushed over you too. So I
yeah.
just cast you.
I mean,
guys
it's
all.
Truly, it is a gush fest. Like she's just an amazing human being. We were saying that she makes you feel like you've known her for years and years when you first meet her. She just has like such a grounding quality to her. And she's just, I don't know. She like checks off all the boxes for me. You know, she's incredible on the show. Like she brings so much to every scene. Like, it's incredible. Everybody in this cast does, though, you know?
What are some things that you guys got to do as a cast in Santa Fe? Did you go out at all?
Some of the things we did, I mean, we did do some karaoke together. There was like a little local karaoke spot. And then they also have an amazing Japanese spa there. And
I was like, going to ask you about that.
Yeah, so like we would go up with like just a few of us would go up together.
What does that mean? Was it like on a mountain?
It was up in the mountain. Yeah.
Okay.
It was gorgeous. It was so pretty. And you wouldn't think like in Santa Fe there'd be a Japanese spa, but it was like pretty authentic and cool.
So Alex does have a lot on his plate with his dad, his relationship, yeah. and his leg.
Yes.
Is it ever hard to actually step into his shoes and kind of experience his life?
The leg was challenging because I obviously have my leg, so I had to kind of really go there with that. But I think that what saved me was Karina was like, you know, he doesn't want anybody to treat him differently because of his injury. He doesn't want to be a martyr because of his injury. So, you know, in this last episode, he's exploring not using his crutch. He wants to figure out how he can like be as mobile as possible and normal as possible. So it's like, that's that inner strength in him that like wants to push through all of the adversity, you know? I mean, because really he has like a rebellious nature. You see in that flashback episode, like he was like goth punk, like rebel, you know what I mean? Like eyeliner, nail polish, and you know, a big you to his dad, you know? All right, I don't know if I can say that, sorry.
All good.
I like that he has that within him, you know?
Yeah.
It can feel dark at times, but you know, honestly, I feel like that role came to me at a time where I was feeling pretty vulnerable and questioning a lot about my life. So it wasn't hard, but it wasn't always fun. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. So if you met an alien in real life, would you be open to dating them? If they were like cool, nice, and you know?
Oh, absolutely. I think aliens, they could probably really be really interesting.
Right?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Not boring.
If you could pick any alien power for yourself to have in real life, what would it be?
I've always wanted to fly.
Okay.
Yeah. Somehow, even if it's like teleportation, I just want to like go somewhere, you know?
Yeah.
At the drop of a hat.
And you get to skip the airport.
Exactly. No TSA.
No TSA. Thank you. That would be amazing. Thank you so much for stopping
by. Yeah, thank
you. This has been such a pleasure.
Thank you.
Guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to watch the next video.